Good morning, everyone. How you feeling? Woo! All right, I'm super excited to be here today to share with you Intuit's machine learning journey, because today marks this very special day and a very special month. Can anybody guess what is so special about this month for us? Good. So we're right at the beginning of tax season, and specifically in less than 2 weeks is April 17th, which itself is actually tax day. Now, back when I was doing my PhD in astrophysics, taxes used to terrify the living daylights out of me. And what I love about working at Intuit now is that I get to build experiences that make such a universally dreaded experience something that is easy and delightful. And the delightful part is really a stretch goal for us, because no one loves doing their taxes. Now, as a company, we have three core products that serves two broad groups of customers. Our Mint and TurboTax products makes personal finance management and tax preparation easy for consumers, and our QuickBooks product simplifies accounting for small business and self-employed. And all of these products work together to serve one mission, to power prosperity around the world. Now, what does prosperity mean? Because it's something that is unique and different for every single individual. For a standard tax filer, it means the tax filing process is easy and simple, so that they can get the largest paycheck of the year in the form of a tax rebate, and also to provide the peace of mind that everything was done properly. For a self-employed individual, such as your Uber driver, this translates into seamless expense tracking, so they can maximize their deductions and ensure that they're getting back every single dollar that they deserve. And as a company, over the past 35 years, we've been constantly evolving our technology to service this one mission. Our journey to the cloud is just the latest in this series of transformations. And it really began in 2013 when we moved our Mint application into AWS. And since then, we've continued to move our infrastructure, applications, data, as well as machine learning capabilities. And as you can imagine, this is a very massive endeavor. We use a wide breadth of AWS services because what it allows for is elasticity. And elasticity is extremely important for a product like ours, because the tax preparation industry is highly seasonal and has very bursty traffic patterns. To give you an example, last year on peak day, there were 2 million tax returns filed in our TurboTax Online product. If you can imagine handling infrastructure to support 2 million per day, that's assuming that we have over 700 million tax filings in 1 year. And we all know that's double the population of the United States and is a total overkill in terms of infrastructure. Because of the nature of our products, any bugs or issues in our products need to be resolved immediately. And so the suite of AWS CI/CD products allows us to quickly deploy any changes to minimize impact on customer experience. And tax data is not the only type of highly sensitive data that our customers entrust us with. We actually have data that requires PCI compliance as well as HIPAA compliance. So that means that our underlying data lake also needs to be highly secure and compliant before we can do any advanced analytics on top. And finally, in the past few years, we've made a really strong push to embed machine learning and AI into our product experiences, and we're really looking forward to scaling this out with our partnership with AWS. What I'm going to go into next is what my team used to have to do to get a machine learning model into production. So as, if I can remind you, I run a data science team of about 20 data scientists, purely only doing machine learning. But what we had to do is, before we could actually take any of our models into production, we had to look at the end-to-end architecture and say, who is going to be using this? Is this going to be an application that's going to be using us? Is it going to be a marketing service? How are they going to use us? Will they expect the result in real time or in batch mode? And finally, for each of the users of our models, what is their SLA requirement? Once that's defined, we then say, we have a model that's built on our laptops, it's an MVP version, now we have to scale it up to production. And that transition means that you need vastly different compute resources. And if those compute resources are not readily available, we would then have to go and provision additional machines in our data centers. And this is a process that usually takes months. If we have all the infrastructure ready to go, the next step is to make sure that this new infrastructure can actually talk to the other machines that we have, as well as have the required ACLs to talk to our data centers. If that is not readily available or open, we then had to go and provision that ourselves again. This adds yet another delay. Now, when you have your model fully built, it's production ready, you really have to think about, how am I going to deliver this model results to the applications or clients that need it, and how will they want it? For most of the models that my team build, we support product features, which means that we need to deliver our model results in real time. And there are two paths that you can go down. What you can do is you can build application code and embed that within your backend application, but that means you're adding to the monolith. The preferred method is to actually build this as a microservice, and that's what my team has had to do, right? And again, a reminder, we're data scientists, we're not backend developers. Building microservices is not our specialty. When that is all done and ready, the last step before production is to make sure that you properly go through and do load testing as well as performance testing on your model before it gets into the hands of customers. And what you see up here is a process that looks to be fairly linear, but in practice, it really isn't, because any change along the way means that you have to go back and revisit the previous step, and you may have to fundamentally change the underlying architecture. Since using SageMaker, all of this is done for us. My data scientists can just be data scientists. No longer do we have to wear so many hats. We don't have to play the role of data architects, data engineers, data QA, data DevOps, data science, as well as backend engineering. SageMaker allows us to be fast and efficient because the underlying architecture is already predefined for us. The compute environments are fully elastic. If my training data set increases in size by 100x, I don't need to make any change other than increasing the size of the EC2 instance. The connection to the data lake is already built in. We don't need to open any additional ACLs. We don't need to deal with exotic database drivers if our underlying data lives within an analytics database that we've never used before. The API endpoints are fully specified as part of the deployment container. We don't have to build our own microservice. It's just a very simple configuration as part of deployment. And my favorite part is that auto-scaling the infrastructure comes out of the box. I do not need to monitor my service or application to make it peak ready. And what this has allowed us to do is cut our deployment time down by 90%. What used to take my team 6 full months to take a model end-to-end now takes us just 1 week. And we're really just scratching the surface of what AWS provides. In the future, we're really looking forward to leveraging the full power of SageMaker, deployment and training, and marrying that with EMR so that we can get to that next state of near real-time model retraining. Higher level services such as AWS Transcribe and Comprehend are going to allow us to fundamentally change the product experience for our users. And we're really, really looking forward to being able to offer greater insights for our customers and get to the state where personalization starts from first sign-on and move to a future state where rather than looking back and telling you what you've been doing in the product to projecting forward and anticipating what you would need next. And all of this means that we can expand the scope of what machine learning can deliver for our customers faster than ever before. And we're very much looking forward to our partnership with AWS to deliver prosperity for our customers. Thank you so much.